Hey, what's up, YouTube? Welcome to 6 Days. I am Bob Six, and today I'm reacting to Lil Darkie making a militia and Monday Gun Day. If you're new to the channel, this is what I do. Real, genuine reactions. When you see me react to a song, that is the first time I've seen and or heard it. I don't read up on them. I don't pre-listen to them, so I know what to expect. It's spur of the moment. So you don't get any of that, whoa, overreacting stuff. You get a real genuine reaction. If it's good, it's good, and if it sucks, it sucks. Either way, I'm gonna tell you exactly what I think about it. That sounds like something you might be into. I'd appreciate it if you would subscribe. And don't forget to click that bell so you know every time I release new content. Let's jump into this. Lil Darkie, make a militia.
You know, I woke up today and my first thought was God bless America. And now I'm here to share with you, something I'm very passionate about. Who you voting for, nigga? I don't even know. At the multi-core, nigga, it can never snow. Surface level bitches gather riches, which is shit to blow. Switch a system with another, I am itching though. Go to school and get that little piece of paper that make you whole. Ain't it cool that you're doing nothing to watch the mountain fall?
Let me stop this for a minute, because I gotta say this before it gets too far away from it. First off, I'm really digging it. I like the vibe, the angry. But he said something in there that kind of shocks people my opinion of it, because I'm not. But he said you sound like you're a racist. A lot of people act like you're not allowed to be racist. You are. I don't support that. I think it's dumb, but you're allowed to be that way. That doesn't give you the right to go around and hurt people or just be a total sack of shit to people. You can be racist without being all that garbage, hurting other people and just run around stirring up shit. So a lot of people these days just start screaming it. I tell people I'm not a racist, I'm a stupidist. Because stupid doesn't have a color. We all have them. They're stupids come in all flavors. I don't like stupid people, because in this day and age, you are making a choice to be stupid. Which, in my opinion, includes racism. But it's your right to be that way. Just like it's your right to be stupid. Yeah. But so many people scream racism or call you a racist. And, you know, racism really exists in today's society. It has always existed. It will always exist. But so many people now are screaming it for no reason. Or that's their trump card. You know, there are people who actually suffer at the hands of racism. You ask your grandparents or your great-grandparents if they're still around. They'll tell you about true, real racism. It's an ugly thing. But there's a lot of people that scream that, you know, because they're a piece of shit and they're trying to get attention off them being a piece of shit. So, in the context of what he said, speaking your mind, saying how you feel, that don't make you a racist. Unless you're saying racist shit because you're a racist.
Killing The car is very foggy.
I really like that. I like the way he said it. Some of my kids don't realize. I realized as soon as I jumped on my own, I moved out of my parents' house at 17 the first time. Paying bills, it is hard. Don't be confused. You know, your parents may be like dumping all that shit on you about the problems they're having and stuff. Making bills. I see a lot of kids just take that for granted. They just want from their parents. Man, it's not that easy. I like that song. Let's check out Monday Gun Day.
You only care about America because someone told you to, don't you, Squidward?
Something I never thought about when I was younger, and I'm sure a lot of people don't think about it today. That kid you're messing with at school, the dork, the loser, the quiet one that doesn't ever defend himself, just sits in the corner. Those are those kids. Not always, but they're those kids. Sometimes they kill themselves, which is horrible. But other times, they pull a gun out and they shoot the punk ass that's been harassing them, picking on them, making their life miserable. And then everybody blames the kid who's being picked on. Now, while I'm not encouraging that to happen, because kids dying is just a terrible thing, but I've seen the way kids are beaten down. I spent a short time as a bully. I've done a video of it. You scroll back to my videos, you'll find it. And I know why I was a bully, but that didn't justify being a bully. I just understand why I was, and I stopped that. But as I got older and matured more and saw more and started defending the dorks that were picked on, beating their bullies up in front of them and showing them they're just a piece of shit. You know, you can do this. But most bullies pick on the weak. But that weak will find an equalizer more often than not and eventually snap. So why don't you keep that in mind? Quit picking on the kid who's not defending himself. He's not bothering you. You want to be a tough guy? Pick on somebody your own size or somebody that you consider to be an equal. Help avoid this. There's too much of that shit going on. Kids killing kids. Now that got pretty deep pretty quick. I dug both those songs, but what he was saying, that was a pretty important message in there about Monday Gun Day. Appreciate y'all hanging out. Hope you have a good day. Make someone laugh. if you get a chance, because we definitely need more laughter in the world. Don't forget to tell your friends and family that you love them each and every time you leave, because you just never know when that'll be the last chance you get to tell them. Until next time, I am Bob Six.